buying or selling? Capital. Good luck to you.
Dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. It's not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
that.
Buying or selling? Capital. Good luck to you.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Bishop Alexander was slain by Satan.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think of it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Buying or selling? Capital. Good luck to you.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know? Back again, eh?
It's free. Fair travels, friend.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right. As long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Back for a return visit. Have at it. Got yourself situated.
Your fish stinks of the void. What kind of rat would sell such filth?
The kind that don't fancy starving, along with the rest of this town.
It's all well and good for you with your rations. We've got to take what we can get.
Keep talking, dwarf, and you'll end up eating sawdust from a cell floor.
Yep.
Glad to see you well. Anything more? Until later, then.
Done thinking?
Oh, I only need one.
Geraldine, that's great news. One each. These will take effect any moment now. I can't thank you enough.
Thank you. Is that thanks enough? My potion's starting to work, Mabel.
Here we go.
God, I'll never see another again.
Better.
It'll be too soon.
Glad to see you. You still have my gratitude. Thanks for keeping quiet about, you know.
I like this place. It's... Oh, hi! Nice to see you. Bye, then. That'll teach you to make assumptions then, won't it?
Hello again. Goodbye again.
Back so soon?
He rubs his leathery hands together with glee.
Sure, sure. For you, that will be a modest sum. And I don't want to hear any whiny little baby noises about it either.
He folds his arms over his ample crimson belly.
You may have the gift of the gab, but I'm a money man, and I won't be going out of business today. That price is as low as I'll go. Pay up, cuckoo! And you were well rewarded for that. I taught you how to be like me. What more could anyone want? If you won't pay, you can't stay. I wish Marg was alive so I could gloat about his death to his face. Back so soon?
He rubs his left.
Sure, and don't even start with me this time. The price is the price.
He smirks as he raises his tree trunk-sized arms overhead and lunges for you. Somehow, you get the feeling that you're actually giving him what he really wants.
Keep it up, puny fleshbag. Your blows mean nothing to me.
To none.
What? What?
I've grown quite fond of this field.
ours.
Thank you.
A haze of flame and confusion envelops you as the Magister's memories hit. You come for Alice Elysium, the witch, and she flees her home. You capture and crucify her, but she returns to life and burns you all.
By the hazing of the shade, I'll kill your shining lights! I'll kill your shining lights! Another world, another life! Thieves and liars, I'd eat their tongues, I'd eat their lives! I'll eat your shining lights! Trouble? Trouble? Bubbling skin and burning knuckles! I'll kill your shining lights! Oh, baby, oh, darling, I'm so sorry! Bubbling skin and burning knuckles! I'll kill your shining lights! A haze of flame and confusion. By the hazing of the shade, I'll kill your shining lights! I'll kill your shining lights! Venomous toad! I'd lick his back and say goodnight! I'd skin him all alive! I'll eat your shining lights! Another world, another life! Thieves and liars! I'd eat their tongues, I'd eat their lives! I'll eat your shining lights! Trouble? Trouble? Bubbling skin and burning knuckle! I'll kill your shining lights! Oh, baby, oh, darling, I'm so sorry. You feel it too, you feel it. Come to me, come, come, and let us kill our shining lights! Bubbling skin and burning knuckle!
Healing!
I'll kill your shining lights!
Before you lies a primitive altar to the Seven, apparently constructed during a bygone era. Something about it appeals to you, a faint heat emanating from the stones, perhaps. The air stirs, as though someone had appeared and taken a seat upon the altar. A voice rises around you, its source unclear. Fractured whispers surround you. Poor thing, the words caress you like a balmy breeze. Look what they've done to you. This burden is not yours to bear. Too much has been asked of you already. I will put this right. How weary you must be. How deserving of respite. Rest. The whispers shuffle away and the air shifts. Whatever was here a moment ago is gone now.
Spinning. You're not straw. I believe.
Go on, then.
What is this place?
around here again? They always put on such a show at those big old heads. Kaboom! Splash! Sizzle!
I see, but you are no elf. This place is not for you. Its trial is not for you to attempt. Very well. You may face the trial. You shall learn all that you need to know. Show patience. Elves know that nature is a finer weapon than even the sharpest blade. The four seasons have served our people well. Four heroes rest before you, wielders of the seasons. Pay homage to their skills, solve their riddle, and prove yourself worthy of elven respect, if you can. Winter shudders with ice and snow. Autumn rumbles. The sky lit aglow. Summer burns, air fiery as a hearth. Spring quenches with bloody rebirth. I am the voice of the fire. My flame bears the will of all elves and lights the way for those who wish to prove their mettle. I see you. Winter shudders with ice and snow.
The totem is still and silent. The totem stares ahead, silent. The totem stands dormant. The totem looms over you. Its lifeless eyes seem to follow you around.
I see you. The trap. Winter shudders with ice and snow. Autumn rumbles, the sky lit aglow. Summer burns, air fiery as a hearth. Spring quenches with bloody rebirth.
The totem looms over you. From within the totem, an otherworldly voice.
Spring. Gentle, so that the others may be strong. The fallen quench the soil with their blood and hasten the rebirth. Death becomes life. As is our way.
I see you. An elf by appearance is not always an elf by heart. Prove yourself. Overcome the trial. A true elf knows that nature is a fine... Pay homage to this. Winter shudders with ice and snow. Autumn rumbles, the sky lit aglow. Summer burns, air fiery as a hearth.
The totem stares ahead, silently. The totem stands dormant. The totem stands dormant. The totem stares ahead. From somewhere within the totem, a voice booms.
Winter, that armors our forest home in ice and snow. Let it make our enemies stumble and fall, and make them easy meals for our spears.
I see you. The winter shudders with ice and snow. Autumn rumbles. The sky lit aglow. Summer burns, air fiery as a hearth. Spring quenches with bloody rebirth.
Thank you.
Quarkus, our shield has gone mad!
The totem stands dormant. The totem stares ahead.